Hello and welcome to another uMake tutorial. This is the third installment on the how to create a hot kettle tutorial series. If you want to learn how we got this shape, definitely check out the previous two lessons that we did. In this tutorial, we're going to add the handle to the lid of the hot kettle and then add a handle to the back of the hot kettle. So to get started, I'm going to go to the side view here, and I'm actually just going to draw an arc shape like that. I think we can do a better one. There we go. Try and make an arc shape that uMake will correct and kind of have the same baseline. And I'm going to then copy this. Tap copy over here. And I'm going to bring this down just a little bit. Make sure copy is off after you move it. And I'm going to scale this in just a little bit and bring it up. There we go. Now, since I drew this from the side view, these two arcs are in the center. And what I actually want to do is simply create a two-way extrusion. So I'm going to select both of them and then tap extrude and make sure to tap two ways. And once I do this, I'll create a two-way extrusion like that. There we go. When I'm done with that, tap the green check mark. And then I'm going to go back to the side view. I'll use the lasso tool down here and I'll draw a selection around both shapes. And I'll just simply move them down into the lid a little bit. There we go. And once I'm done, I can simply create a surface between them. So double tap on each of these curves. And once you see them in green, I'll simply tap the create surface here and do that on the other side. And we have the handle for the lid. Pretty easy. You can definitely experiment with the width of the handle, the location, the shape, etc. Now let's create the handle for the back of the hot kettle. Basically, what we're going to do is create an extrude along path shape. So we're sweeping a profile along a path. So I'm just going to draw a curve like this. This is how I like to do it. And I'm going to go into edit mode, tap once to go into edit mode, and I'm basically going to start moving points around. So move this point here, and then add a couple of points. Move this up here. If you ever want to make kind of a right angle curve and you make, the easiest way to do it is use 3 points. So usually I try and have a point kind of out here, and then the actual change in direction in the curve, I use 3 points like that. Add another point down here. Basically what I'm doing is just adding some points to this curve to change its overall shape. Now that kind of looks elegant, so I'll just bring this down like that. And essentially what you need is just create a nice shape that looks good. I like this. And once you have this curve and you're happy with it, tap the green check mark once you're done, and we have this curve here. Now we want something a little bit more solid, so what we're going to do is draw a profile. So we'll go back to, let's see, the back view here. And now we want something to extrude along that path. So I'm going to draw a circle, get rid of the surface, double tap on the surface, and just kind of get rid of that by tapping erase. I'll double tap on this circle again, and I'm going to use this bounding box and just kind of squish this a little bit. And then I will bring this straight down, go to the side view, and bring this back. And kind of what I want to do is align it with the end of this curve here. There we go. And once that's selected, I'm going to select this curve here. Go to extrude. Turn two ways off. I'm going to go to along path. And once I get along path, I'm just going to drag this yellow dot along the path that I drew and just kind of pull it down like that. and you'll see that I have a nice handle. That looks good. Once I'm done, tap the green check mark, and we have the handle to the hot kettle. So that's it. That's pretty much all the steps to get to the hot kettle. Now you can definitely experiment changing the colors and everything. So if you want to select everything here, you can come up to the top, you can add a material to it. I can make this like a nice white plastic or something. I can add a color to it. We'll do like a red or something. And you now have a nice looking little hot kettle. This is basically a good tutorial to get familiar with some of the features like extrude along path, some lofting, and the push-pull tools in uMake. I hope that this mini series was helpful. If you have any comments, questions, or feedback for us, definitely let us know. We can't wait to see what you create. You can find us on our YouTube channel, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. So definitely show us your kettles or your creations in uMake. Take care and have a great day, guys.